Y bienvenido a la embajadora de El Salvador. Welcome to the ambassador of El Salvador y el consular general, the consul general. Me enorgullece ofrecer la resolución de esta mañana pidiendo al presidente y al Congreso que extiendan TPS y DACA. Y quiero agradecer al vicepresidente Navarro por trabajar conmigo en esto, así como a delegada Ana Sol Gutiérrez, quien ha sido un infalible campeón de nuestros electores que necesitan esta protección. Es nuestro deber exigir al Congreso y al Poder Ejecutivo del Gobierno Federal a trabajar juntos para extender el estatus de protección temporal, TPS, para todas las naciones actualmente incluidas en el programa y para establecer un camino hacia la residencia permanente para los beneficiarios de TPS y DACA, acción diferida para los llegados en la infancia. Este es otro golpe devastador para nuestra comunidad inmigrante. Hay casi 800,000 beneficiarios de DACA a nivel nacional y más de 9,700 beneficiarios de DACA en el estado de Maryland. Estos hombres y mujeres jóvenes trabajan con éxito, van a la escuela y contribuyen a sus comunidades. Es muy lamentable que esta nueva administración haya dejado de aceptar nuevas aplicaciones para las protecciones de DACA y los destinatarios actuales verán que sus protecciones terminan cuando caduque su actual autorización de 2 años. Las protecciones de TPS para nacionales de El Salvador, Honduras, Haití, Nicaragua y otros países han estado vigentes durante aproximadamente 20 años. A nivel nacional, hay más de 325,000 titulares de TPS. Maryland alberga a casi 22,000 beneficiarios de TPS, el segundo mayor número de beneficiarios de TPS en el país. TPS brinda protección contra la deportación y otorga autorización de empleo a individuos de países que han experimentado conflictos armados, desastres ambientales u otras condiciones que amenacen la vida. It's a point of pride for me to offer the resolution this morning asking the President and Congress to extend TPS and DACA. And I want to thank Vice President Navarro for working with me on this, and I particularly want to recognize Delegate Ana Sol Gutierrez, who has been an incredible champion of our constituents who need this protection. It is our duty to urge Congress and the executive branch of the federal government to work together to extend TPS for all nations currently included in the program and to institute a path to permanent residency for TPS and deferred action for childhood arrivals or DACA recipients. This is another devastating blow to our immigrant community. There are nearly 800,000 DACA recipients nationwide and more than 9,700 DACA beneficiaries in the state of Maryland. These young men and women successfully work, go to school, and contribute to their communities. It is very unfortunate that the new administration has immediately stopped accepting new applications for DACA protection, and current DACA recipients will see their protection end when their current 2-year authorization expires. TPS protection for nationals of El Salvador, Honduras, Haiti, Nicaragua, and other countries have been in place for about 20 years. Nationwide, there are more than 325,000 TPS holders. Maryland is home to nearly 22,000 TPS recipients, and it is the second largest number of TPS beneficiaries in the United States. TPS provides protection from deportation and grants employment authorization to individuals from countries that have experienced armed conflict, environmental disasters, or other life-threatening conditions. It is short-sighted and counterproductive to terminate DACA and TPS beneficiaries. It would harm Montgomery County by negatively impacting the lives of long-term county residents, separating parents from their U.S.-born children, and hurting our local economy. I thank my colleagues for their support of this resolution.
Well, thank you very much. We really appreciate your efforts and all the job that you have been doing for our people. Me, as a representative from the government of El Salvador, I want to show you that we are really grateful with you, with all the job that you're doing, with all the support that you give for our people, we want to tell you that we really think that these resolutions, this initiative, shows the love that you have for our people, but especially it shows and it enhances the values and the principles of the people of the United States of America. The love, the solidarity, the friendship, the democracy, the interest that we have for building better societies. So we want to show you our gratitude, and we want to tell you again that we really believe in our people, that we really believe that our people contribute to this society with their work, with the cultural contributions, with all the contributions that also their children and their family gives to their country. So we think that we can be here together working with you. As you know, we do a job for asking the extension of the TPS, but we are also working in the Congress in terms of getting a permanent residence for our people. We count on you. We think that we're going to continue making this job, and we will have the support for this country. I also want to tell you that I really do believe that this city, especially Montgomery County, is the one of the best of the world. Even if I just came, I have one year and some months of living here in this country. I really feel a pleasure to come here. You're really good people. Your friendship, your love, your trust, your confidence makes me feel that I'm really at home, that I'm really at my country. And that's why I think that all my people feels to be with you. So thank you very much. Quiero pues igual saludar a todos mis compatriotas que están aquí. Ellos saben de los esfuerzos que hemos hecho como gobierno de El Salvador y también como otros gobiernos que han participado por la extensión de este beneficio para toda nuestra gente. En todo momento participamos remarcando la gran contribución que ellos han dado a la sociedad norteamericana con su trabajo, con sus aportes culturales, con sus aportes a la educación. También hay otro elemento importante y es que, bueno, vamos creciendo como crece la humanidad y vamos construyendo familias, vamos construyendo niños, jóvenes con valores, con principios que también hacen grande esta sociedad y el mundo en general. Así es que una vez más les quiero agradecer en nombre de mi comunidad, en toda nuestra comunidad TPS y en nombre de toda nuestra comunidad DACA, por la presentación de esta resolución. Muchas gracias.
Thank you. Ms. Peña, would you like to add something?
Yes, just to give you the thanks. We appreciate that the resolution, and also I wanted to tell you that I'm a resident from Montgomery County, and we also, last year we decided to move the Consul General from Wisconsin Avenue in Georgetown to Silver Spring in Montgomery County. So, and this is the place where a lot of connationals from El Salvador and Honduras that are TPS holders, this is the home base to get meetings, to training, to plan a lot of things, to go to the Congress, and this is the home base of Alianza para National TPS Alianza. Yes, and I'm very proud of having this place in Montgomery County that is a very friend community, and well, we appreciated all the support that you gave us and as all, and my government is always working in the higher level, but we are organizing people and we are working with the people as well. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We appreciate you brought a lot of life in moving that organization, brought a lot of life to that corner of Silver Spring. Thank you. Yeah, Delegate Gutierrez, would you like to add something?
Thank you. Thank you very much. I will not extend myself other than to thank the council, because it's so very important for Montgomery County to recognize that these are individuals that live, are residents in Montgomery County. For many, this is the first time they come to their government. And that is why it's so important to have you recognize who they are, and the rest of Montgomery County to recognize who they are. We have here the head of transportation, school bus transportation, many of the drivers that have CDL because they have TPS are able then to provide that important service for our children. We have individuals here who work for our disposal. They pick up our trash. They are also able to have that job, good paying jobs, because they have TPS and they have a CDL. We have so many people that every day are working to make this community better, to provide the services. And that's why I would like to just take a moment to recognize them if they're able to stand up and we can give them a round of applause.
Thank you. Please,
por favor,
please
si stand. Se paran para reconocer su trabajo en favor de Montgomery County.